And away we go. Well, this is me, as ridiculous as it is. I was born at a time where there was peace and not, and I was a happy, hungry, curious baby. My schooling started with Catholic school, which didn't go so well. Mother Superior didn't like me. I was a little too creative and a little bit too inquisitive about things. My family connected through a couple of things, mostly through, oh my gosh, connection, which seems redundant, but that's the way we did things. I was a child easily bribed by ice cream. Well, we loved entertainment, we loved connection, we loved art and literature. It was one of the things that really helped our family come together. I was also obsessed with television, particularly Mr. Hooper of Sesame Street. Albuquerque is a unique place. We have huge wealth inequality, cultural inequality, racial inequality. However, what brings us together is our diversity. Yes, diversity is what brings us a sense of unity. Albuquerque is a mix of great, beautiful cultural resources and a sense of honesty and desperation that is kind of hard to hide. We're a mix of mix. Somos mezclandos. We are all about mixing of everything, but that is also the thing that causes problems when you're in middle school. You're figuring out the world in a brand new way. And thankfully, when I was fairly young, I found some things, and recently I found things having to do with complex adaptive systems that helped me understand the world in a clearer way. Our culture, again, is one of diversity and connection. My family valued life and learning quite a bit, and they still do, thankfully. The most beautiful parts of my American culture is our art, and the least beautiful is the hate, which is part of our cultural DNA, which is something that hopefully all of us here from Albuquerque can work on. Politics, not exactly a fan of it, but it's a necessary evil, like wiping your bottom or cleaning the dishes when you're done. It's something that needs to occur, but we don't have to necessarily like it. It is the way we organize our love for one another, or I suppose our hate. Well, the politicians really should be supporting the least among us. We should be thinking about water and pipelines, solar on every building, free universal mental health care. This is what our country needs and what we have paid for. Not just guns. I don't think politicians necessarily are listening to us, but if we don't vote, guess what? We don't get listened to. So 2/3 of Americans do not actually vote regularly. The more regularly we vote, the more often we will get what we want. And at the end of the day, our society may be occurring at a time of great transition. I hope that we find love and avoid zombieism. Our phones can be quite addictive. We want to be unique, but not unique and identical to everyone else. I think our future, we can't eat money, but we can live on a world full of humans and full of life that coexist. If we do that, our present moment, which seems like a jump through the midair, might end up being a jump into a more elevated, verdant, and loving world where we can love, be loved, and become something more. This has been just a little bit about me.